Hi folks, welcome back. We're still working on this ornament for this Hobo Santa, and I just did two passes there. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a little line for the mouth here, just like so, a little curvature line. What you're going to do is you're going to take your knife and you're going to stab it in there pretty far, but take your time. Don't want to put too much pressure on that knife. You don't want to break that knife, okay? They're too expensive to replace, so especially if you bought some good knives along the way. Folks, if this is your first time watching, go to a carving show. They have everything you could imagine under the sun to buy what you need. All right, so if you need to get anything, that's a good way of finding it, is online. And and going to a carving show is an excellent way to check out the products and try it out. I know I repeat that a lot, but I highly recommend if you get a chance to go this fall. There's a lot more carving shows in the fall than in the summer. The summer's kind of slow with everything. Everybody's on vacation and that kind of thing. So, all right, so we have that mouth out pretty good. I have to clean it up a little bit, get some of those things. You don't ever want to pry anything out with your knife, okay? We're going to go back up here, and we're going to round this mustache off. We're going to go this way first, because the grain is running this way. So we're going to round that off. And we're going to turn it around, and we're going to round that off right there. Kind of blend that in. Same thing over here. Now, see, that's not really deep there. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a little triangular shape cut there, right where the nose and the beard and the cheek meet. See how that just made it just a little bit different, okay? And I've got a lot to clean up here when I get done, folks, since this is not over with by any means. But what you want to do is try to be very careful when you get to some of these corners and stuff. It's very easy to chip something out. We're going to round off the rest of the mustache here, okay, down to the mouth here, just like so, and do the other side. There, I can see it a little better like that. Okay. That's how you round it off. And you know, I may go back and make this all a little bit deeper, and I think I'll do that offline where I can see it a little bit better. But when we come back, what we need to do also is his shoulders here. It looks like it's part of a body here, so we're going to do this. This is the extending of his arms here, and the little part to his jacket, the white part of the bottom part of his jacket. Lean it against the table again. Take your heavier knife and make a stop cut like so. One over here. I'm going to turn that around. It's a little safer than... Your greatest way to slip is when you get near your edges. And somebody said that on a bulletin board, and that's very true. And I felt maybe I should mention that in my carvings. That is very true. When you get to your edges, it's when you do most of your slipping. And see how I'm doing this with the knife? It controls it perfectly. You know, it keeps it from slipping all over the place. If I just was doing it like this, I could not have that control to get near that the way I did. So a lot of it's controlling your knife. You know, that's a lot of, that will avoid a lot of your cuts. Not being tired when you carve, and don't drink when you carve also helps. To be careful, you know, that you're not. So see how we have that 3D effect there for his shoulder. We're going to do the same thing over here. We're going to see how I'm pulling that to me now. And that's perfectly okay. That's a way of controlling that knife as well. Alright folks, I'm going to dig this out just a tad over here in the corner. Get that cleaned up a little bit. Alright, so that's looking good. Now we're going to put two little cuts here. We're just going to push them in, just like so. And I'm going to push that one in. And that one. Keep your hands out of the way. And right there. Okay? And a lot of that's just going to be a V-cut. Like so. And like so. This will be actually cut out so it can see it's his part of his jacket. These are a lot faster to do than in the round. I'm just going to cut that up a little further. Okay. And again, you want to just put a little V cut there. One and two. Alright. So that should be your arms and your jacket portion. Now we're going to round off the beard. Let's see what... Well, we got a little bit of time yet. I'm going to start rounding off this beard a little bit here. All the way around. Won't be too long. We'll be ready to paint them. And, Alright, folks. So when we come back, we'll finish up putting the lines everywhere for his beard, which is a very important portion of it. And that didn't take us all that long. It really was a pretty quick project. I need to do a lot more to the tassel at the top here. We have a lot to clean off with the sides, so if you want to start doing that, you can. See how I'm cleaning all this off? This is going to stay natural wood anyway. The cheeks will stay natural. The nose will stay natural, but this will be white, 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 red, and red, and white. So really all you need is red and white, okay? And we've got to do the tassel yet. So there's a few little projects to do yet. We'll be back.